Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to the class. I am Senu Thakur Jaiswal, and as you all know, if you are following the channel, we were discuss about a very important examination, that is PTE, Pearson Test of English Examination. This examination is for if you want to study abroad, so this examination is really very useful for you. So these are the standardized tests designed to assess your English proficiency, and through these tests, you can get enrolled in around 3,500 university globally. Okay, so let's start today's class. As I have discussed about the rest part. Okay, I'm just showing you the yes. In this slide, you will see there are three part. Okay, part one, part two, and part three. Just a second. Yes. So in part one, there is speaking and writing, which consumes approx 77 to 93 minutes. Part two, reading, and part three, listening. I have already done part one with you. If you don't see that video, so please go through these videos. That is already on the channel. I have uploaded all the videos connected to this part. And today I'm going to tell you something about reading, okay? So let's start. There are options for multiple choice, single answer, multiple choice, many answer, reorder paragraphs, fill in the blanks, and fill in the blanks, drag and select. So these are the different part. This video will may be converted into two parts in reading sessions particularly. So let's start our session. Okay. So PTE reading text. In this text, I'm going to give you some example, some practice text, and through these tests, you can easily evaluate yourselves how you should be ready for that test. Okay, so are you ready, guys? So please, if you like the video, just click a button so that I can make some more interesting videos for you. Okay, let's start. So this is our first practice paper. Okay, so this is how you will you will be getting your paper as it is, same. So this is the pattern where you can see the paper, the question, okay? And here is the question. Short passage is there. You have to read this passage, and there are some options. You have to correct the response, okay? And here you have to read out the instruction first. There are only one response is correct, because in upcoming questions or practice questions, you will see you have to tick on multiple responses. Okay, but here they are asking for the only one response. Okay, let's start. The first practice question is, many argue that art cannot be defined. We could go about this in several ways. So art is often considered as the process or product of deliberately arranging elements in a way that appeals to the senses or emotions. It encompasses a diverse range of human activities, creations, and ways of expressions, including music, literature, film, sculpture, and paintings. The meaning of art is explored in a branch of philosophy known as aesthetics. At least, that is what Wikipedia claims. What is the main idea of the passage? Art is a difficult and complex form to explain. Wikipedia defines art under aesthetics, which is a branch of philosophy. Music, literature, film, and sculpture do not define art. Art is directed in a way that it deliberately appeals to the emotions of people. So tell me, guys, which is the right answer? I hope you have given a right answer. Let's check our answer. Click about submit. So this answer is right. That's why it's showing in green. So let's move on with the next question. This is a big passage, so we'll move with yes. This is nice. Excise taxes are governmental levies specific on goods produced and consumed inside a country. Okay. They differ from tariffs, which usually apply only to foreign made goods, and from sales taxes, which typically apply to all commodities other than those specifically exempted. So in this paragraph, we are talking about excise duties and tariffs, the difference between those. In their modern form, excise taxes were first developed by Holland in the 17th century and established by law in England in 1643. Okay. Introduced into the Dutch colonies in America, the system spread to other colonies. Such taxes were first used by the federal government in 1791 and aroused great oppositions. They were repealed in Thomas Jefferson administration in 1802. During the War of 1812, comprehensive excise taxes were levied again but were repealed in 1817. Okay, so you can call this number 1802, 1802, 1802. Okay, yes, now we'll see the instruction. Read the text and answer the multiple choice question, selecting the correct response. Only one response is correct. Carefully, guys, you have to read your instruction first. This is very, very important, because in upcoming examination, you will feel why I am saying this. Okay, because there is multiple responses is also there. So according to this text, how do excise taxes usually differ from tariffs? Excise taxes are levied on all products. Have we read that? While tariff applied to government-made goods? No. Excise taxes are levied on specifically identified commodities, while tariffs apply to all goods. And dear friends, this is really important. For this passage or this kind of question, you will have only 2 minutes. Okay? So you have to complete this question within your time limit. So my answer is, excise taxes are levied on specifically identified commodities, while tariffs apply to all goods. Let's check the answer. Wrong. Yes, this is the way. When you click something wrong, your answer showing the same way. Okay. Excise tax, we have already read about that. That excise tax are levied on goods produced and consumed in one country, while tariff applied to imports. Okay. Is it clear to you? So we have confused by some words, so that can be happened with anyone, as I have given you example. So let's move on with the next question. Okay, this is okay. Let's do something with multi. Yes, here you will need to select more than one response. Okay, let's read this. By the laws of probability, most decision made under pressure should be flawed once. Yet psychologists have found that people routinely make correct judgment most of the time, even with limited information. One of Gladwell's surprising point is that we can actually learn how to make better snap judgment in the same way that we can learn logical, deliberative thinking. But first, we have to accept the idea that thinking long and hard about something does not always deliver us better results, and that the brain actually involved to make us think on our feet. So, what is the question? Which of the following does the passage tell us about decision making? Okay, the brain is designed to enable quick decision making. Is it so? Yes, I'm pretty sure this is right. Number two. Quick decision making can be improved. Can we do that? Yes, because this is our weakness. We always do this. We have done our decision in a quick way, and this is not good for us. Okay. The quick decision making can be improved. Quick decision making routinely leads to error. Maybe. To make correct decision, we require all relevant information. No, sometimes we don't have time to get all the connected information. Thinking things through thoroughly will lead to greater success. No, this is not right. Let's check our answer. Yes, these 2 points is right. So this is the method. You can select your right answer. I hope I'll help you in this way. Okay. So, in our next class, we'll meet soon with the third and the last part of this PT reading test, because I have to discuss some more examinations which definitely help you for your further abroad studies. Okay. So thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care. We'll meet soon in our next class. Please like and share, subscribe. Thank you so much.